What's up, everybody? Are y'all excited to start the video? Well, shut the hell up and look at my new Ridge wallet. I got a new Ridge wallet, y'all. I'm sorry, I'm just excited, bro. You know me.
Get the lookin'!
We live in the future, everybody. This is like a future wallet. We got drones. We got wallets, man. And not that type of wallet. I hate that wallet. Let's get rid of these, man. They're so awkward and they bunch up in your pocket all the time. I only still have this one to do commercials and roast it or whatnot.
It's embarrassing to be seen with you.
My Ridge wallet is sleek and minimalist and cool looking. And it feels way better in your pocket. You can still feel it. It feels secure, but it don't hurt your ass or whatever like the old fashioned wallets do. You don't have to put it in your back pocket either. You could put it in your front pocket. You could put it in your other front pocket. It's super durable and it can hold up to 12 cards. Plus, of course, it's got room for your cash. They let you choose either the money strap or the money clip, or whichever one you want. You got over 30 different colors and styles to choose from also. They got stuff for big gangsters like myself. I got the titanium joint this time, the one with the stonewashed design. It's real classy. Get that one too, bro. We could be matching. And they got stuff for the ladies too. You might be the ladies. Would you like flowers and shit? I don't know, lady. You got options though, is what I'm saying. Different colors, all that. The best part is, each wallet comes with a lifetime warranty, so it's the last wallet you'll ever need to buy. They'll fix it or replace it for you forever, bro. Plus, they all come with a 45-day money-back guarantee. You might as well try it. You'll get your money back if you don't like it. They got over 30,000 five-star reviews. It's probably way more than that now. Now that I made them popping single-handedly, everybody want a Ridge now because of me. Get 10% off plus free shipping worldwide by going to ridge.com/prim and using the promo code PRIM at checkout. The link is in the description for you. Again, you get 10% off and free shipping worldwide. Don't forget the promo code. Use mine, bro. Don't use nobody else's code. I swear to God. Thanks again, Ridge Wallet people, for sponsoring the boy. Now it's time for R. Kelly, unfortunately. It starts off with R. Kelly sleeping peacefully in the bed. He's waking up and the sun is beaming down on his cornrows or whatever. Look at this little ass twin size bed, R. Kelly. This shit don't even look comfortable at all. It's like a little kid bed, bro. What are you doing here? Oh yeah, that's right.
7 o'clock in the morning and the rays from the sun wakes me. I'm stretching and yawning in a bed that don't belong to me.
Okay, so already, how is this nigga in the bed and the closet at the same time? Is two R. Kelly sometimes? Is that part of the story or something? I hope not. So some big titties walk into the scene and there's a lady attached to him. The lady starts singing in R. Kelly's voice and she's all like, I had a good time last night, R. Kelly, when we was smashing or something. Everybody's singing in R. Kelly's voice, by the way. I hate it.
Here I am quickly trying to put on my clothes. Searching for my car keys, trying to get on up out the door.
The chick tells R. Kelly that she's married and her husband is actually coming through the door any second. Now they gotta come up with a plan.
I said, why don't I just go out the window? Yes, except for one thing, we on the fifth floor. Shit, think, shit, think, shit, quick, put me in the closet.
You could go out the window, R. Kelly. You could fly, remember? I believe I could fly. He got shot by the FBI and whatnot. Y'all remember that? All he wanted was some chicken wings? Whatever, man. The wife shoves R. Kelly inside the closet and she gives him this hat so he can keep his cornrows warm in the closet. The husband comes home wearing this tiny ass little sweater and he's all happy and kissing on his wife.
He hops all over him and says, I've cooked and ran your bath water. Telling you now, this girl's so good that she deserves an Oscar.
The husband and the wife are making out or whatever, and R. Kelly's in the closet singing by himself. Next thing you know, a call comes through on R. Kelly's cell phone.
Next thing you know, a call comes through on my cell phone.
He tries to turn it off, but it's too late, and the husband already knows something is up. Yeah, flip phones be buzzing loud as shit, bro. You done for. There's no way he didn't hear that shit. The husband starts looking around for R. Kelly now, and he's singing to his wife about how angry he is.
He walks in the bathroom and looks behind the door. She says, baby, come back to bed. He says, bitch, say no more. Checks under the bed, then opens the dresser. He looks at the closet. I pull out my Beretta.
Damn, bro, this nigga looked in the dresser. What the fuck? You're not thinking straight, sir. R. Kelly can't fit inside the dresser. He's in the closet, obviously. Check in the closet.
Now he's at the closet. Now he's opening the closet.
The husband and the Pied Piper are having a staring contest now. The wife tries to explain, but the husband don't want to hear it. He says he always knew she was a hoe, but he a good Christian man, and he gave her a shot anyway.
He said, "Hoe, I should have known that you would go and do some bogus shit up in my house. But the Christian in me gave you the benefit of the doubt."
Just then, R. Kelly grabs that hat out of the closet, and he tells their side of the story.
"I met this girl at the Pages Club, and she told me she didn't have a man. He steps a little closer. I point my gun and says, 'I'm not the one you after.' He says, 'Some, I bet you didn't know my man. Did she tell you that I was a pastor?'"
The pastor and the wife start arguing some more, and R. Kelly tries to leave, finally, like he should have bended. The pastor stops him, though, and tells him that he's got a secret to reveal.
He says, "No, I want you to see this. Said I gotta get out this house and not tell her, reveal my secret." Then he takes his phone and calls somebody up and says, "Hello, baby, turn the car around."
"What are you doing, R. Kelly? You letting this nigga call for backup and shit? Oh no, you got a gun, bro. You don't even have to stay there if you don't want to. Why are you still here, actually? This doesn't seem smart to stick around, bro."
He looks at me and says, "Well, since we're all coming out the closet, I'm not about to be the only one that's brokenhearted. Then I knock on the door, the gun's in my hand. He opens the door, I can't believe it's a man.
Okay, that's fine if he's gay. Why did you need R. Kelly to stay here for this again? You don't know this nigga. Why was it so important for him to be here right now? Also, y'all know R. Kelly was probably feeling himself when he wrote this part. Everybody saw that coming, bro. You're not a good writer. Everybody's shocked that the pastor is gay and having an affair. It's mostly the gay thing, though, that they're mad about. Why is everybody so surprised? Look at this little ass sweater, bro.
Get him!
Everybody's singing again, and they're using the same fucking beat again. They're not gonna change this beat, are they? You should have used different beats for different chapters, bro. That would have been lit, actually. If it was a whole album with different beats and vibes instead of a 2-hour song, what the fuck?
Here we are, the four of us, in total shock, me and her. Then I said, "So you're gonna tell me he's the one you've been talking to?" He says, "Yes." I says, "No." He says, "Yes." I says, "No." He says, "It's the truth."
Nigga, mind your business. What does it matter who he's been talking to? Just leave. Why did you even let him call somebody? This nigga could have came up here bussing on you, bro. You don't know these niggas. This shit already don't make any sense. There's no way I'm watching this whole shit.
I yell, "All of y'all asses crazy. Let me up out this door. Because this is way more. And I'm bargaining for."
All y'all ass is crazy? Why? Cause he gay, R. Kelly? You ridiculous, bro. You smashed his wife and now you mad at him. All right. Plus, you the last nigga who should be judging somebody's sexual preferences. At least they both adults, nigga.
Stop it.
R. Kelly finally starts leaving, but the wife stops him and says we can fix all this? Fix what? You don't know this nigga. What are you fixing? What could he possibly help you with at this point?
"I'm sure we can all fix this." And then she said, "But wouldn't you like to know just how it all began?" Then I thought to myself and said, "Quick, you got 3 minutes.
What? What does it matter how it began, bro? Leave! This shit is so stupid. I'm about to turn this shit off, bro. They could have at least thought of an excuse for him to be stuck here. He lost his keys or his phone or some shit. He's trying to find them while they're singing. Boom, there you go. Everybody else can still sing about the gayness and the marriage drama or whatever. And he can still sing too while he's looking for his shit. He finds it in the closet or something. I don't know, man. I'm trying to make the shit make sense. It don't make sense that he's still here.
Then Rufus said, "Chuck, please don't say nothing else." And then she screams, "Rufus, you son of a bitch." And he says, "Kathy, go to hell." I said, "I thought your name was Mary. It's what you said at the party."
Nigga, what's up with these names? Rufus, Kathy, and Mary? You picked the first names that came to your mind, R. Kelly. Who fucking helped you make all this shit, bro? That's who I'm really mad at. It's not your fault, bro. It's their fault.
Then Rufus started yelling and screaming, saying, "Kathy, this is all your fault." She throws a pillow at him and says, "You was screaming too. The only difference is you didn't get caught." Then I shoot one in the air. Then I say, "Not another one of you sons of bitches say a word. Cause all of this shit I'm going through is unheard."
I pray to God there's no sixth floor, bro. You probably killed somebody just now. What's wrong with you, nigga? You in an apartment, remember? Also, side note, why y'all got this fucking lamp on, bro? It's fucking daytime. Turn the shit off, man. I hate that. R. Kelly says he's done helping them and he wanna go home. He calls his house, but some dude picks up the phone. Now that's the end of that part. Let's keep going, bro. Fuck.
Now I'm down.
Fuck this shit.
I've got a million thoughts going through my mind.
Jesus Christ, this shit look horrible, man. Wow. Okay, I'm back into it. This is good. This is what I came for. I'm having fun again. R. Kelly gets pulled over by Omar from The Wire. He's a cop in this, I guess? Okay, sure, whatever. He an all-star. I didn't expect to use this shit today. Notice when he's pulling R. Kelly over, this is like a real street. I mean, it's not real, but he's like really driving the car here for a few seconds. Why did they use the green screen? Why not just film him driving? It's probably because he was speeding. They didn't want to make him drive fast. Whatever, man. Moving on. This is the least of our problems right now.
And then I said, officer, let me explain, please. You see, the truth of the matter is that I've got an emergency.
The cop tells R. Kelly that he was going too fast and he gotta take this ticket. R. Kelly tells him that he got an emergency, but Omar don't give a fuck really. That's not really an emergency, by the way. Just throwing that in there.
I said yeah, right, and drove away. And then I turned my radio on and did 55 all the way home. I pull up in the driveway, hop out and slam the car door.
His house is green screen too? Look at this fucking fake ass house. This whole thing looked like a Mad TV skit. My thing is, why did you make this whole long ass project, R. Kelly, if you weren't gonna put no money into it? You clearly didn't have enough money for this shit, bro. This shit is so cheap.
Go around the back, bust up in the house. Then I'm like, woman, I called this house and a man picked up my phone. And she says, come down, did you forget my brother Twan came home?
R. Kelly realizes that it was all just a misunderstanding and he turns on some music and they start smashing now, I guess. There's a condom wrapper still on the bed, so I guess this bitch really was up to something after all. Why didn't you get rid of that shit? You had time. Anyway, they smashing now, like I said, and R. Kelly gets a cramp in his leg, so he taps out. Then he pulls the covers back randomly, and he finds the condom wrapper in the most hilarious way possible.
Oh my God, a rubber, 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 rubber.
Damn, poor R. Kelly. What made him pull the covers back like that randomly, though? What was that for?
Well, 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 what the fuck is this? A condom in my bed. You better start talking, bitch, before I take a match and burn this motherfucker down.
This nigga singing the bleeps now? Are you fucking with me, R. Kelly? This nigga trolling, bro. Why would you just now start bleeping it? You've been cussing this whole time.
Some shit is going down. Shit ain't shit up in my house.
Don't you think kids watching this shit? Ain't nobody watching this bullshit but me, R. Kelly. There must be a limit on cuss words or something. Anyway, it turns out the dude she was cheating with was Omar, the cop that stopped him and shit earlier. Crazy twist, sure. That's the whole part five. It's just the reveal of that. They say a bunch of random nonsense to fill in the time, but yeah, that's pretty much it.
Wipes her nose and then asks me about a girl named Tina. I thought to myself, did it sound familiar? She said he know my girl Roxanne's guy named Chuck. Chuck's cool with this guy named Rufus. And I'm sitting there like, what the fuck? She introduced me to the policeman that stopped you.
R. Kelly just starts laughing or whatever. Now they forgive each other because they was both cheating. Have you ever been in a real relationship, R. Kelly? Nobody's acting normal in this shit, bro. I can't describe it.
Then I start laughing again and she start laughing more. Then next thing you know, we both are cracking up on the floor.
Meanwhile, Twan just got out of prison and he's on his way
Meanwhile,
home.
Meanwhile, Twan just got out of prison and he's on his way home.
Hey, this nigga walking like a Grove Street nigga. You an old Brian Pumper looking ass nigga. Oh, LL Cool J looking ass nigga. I'm sorry, bro. This man ain't been on the screen 5 seconds. I'm already trying to roast him. I apologize, bro.
Baby, this is no lie. He had a lover, turns out to be a gay guy. She says, damn, you've been through a lot of shit, plus I got a ticket.
R. Kelly starts telling his girl all about his morning and his closet adventures. Then we cut over to Omar, and he's actually turning the car around to make sure the girl is okay.
Meanwhile, the police, he turns around. Shit. Comes back to the house. He gets to the back door and discovers it's been broken in.
Omar gets to the house and he sees the back door has been kicked in. I don't remember R. Kelly kicking the door. He probably did though, I don't know. I'm pretty tired of watching this shit, man. What part is this, bro?
Meanwhile, we're laughing and laughing and laughing, but from his perspective, he thinks somebody's crying. She yells out, Sylvester, you're killing me. I said, I swear that it went that way.
Omar mistakes the laughing for crying, and a bunch of other stupid, convoluted ass shit happens to where he think R. Kelly's killing the girl. You can't tell laughing from crying, man. It's not a good trait as a cop, bro. Also, what's this nigga name? Sil my fucking Vester, nigga? What's all these country ass names for, R. Kelly? His girl's name is Gwendolyn and shit? Rufus? I thought you was from Chicago, bro. You country as fuck. And it was so fucking funny, bro. How long they been laughing? Are they laughing this hard off the gay pastor? Grow up, bro.
The next thing you know, he bust up in a room and said, motherfucker free. She says, everything is cool. And then he yells, Gwendolyn, I got this. I know you're sick and tired of this fool.
Omar and R. Kelly are having a standoff now. R. Kelly pulled the gun out again, of course. You can make a drinking game out of this shit, bro. Mind you, we only on part 6, and this whole shit is falling apart already. Like, he's not even trying to flow correctly anymore. He's literally just singing long-ass, run-on sentences. This shit barely rhymes now.
She cried out to Vesta, please don't. Visions of him making love to her. He said, man, put the gun on the floor. I can't stop thinking about him and her. So Vesta, now hold on. Even though he was in our home, let's not forget the fact that you was out there creeping in another man's home.
It's weird, because the first couple parts of this aren't actually that terrible. Like, they got the whole closet motif. R. Kelly's in the closet. The pastor was in the closet. It was something, at least. The rest of this shit is just nonsense. This nigga was clearly just writing anything. What is this?
And then I put my hands up. He winked at me and smiled. And that is when I went. She's screaming.